Hello everyone, I am Prakash Mohd, working as an assistant professor in Computer Science and Engineering Department at G.H. Rai Soni Institute of Engineering and Technology. Dear student, last lecture we have seen the finite automata, that is the one part of the computational model. As there are different kind of the computational model, that is finite automata is one, second is a push down automata and third is a Turing machine. So last lecture we have seen the different method that how to calculate the finite state automata. Now today we'll see the Turing machine. This is the one kind of the model which we see in today's sessions. So Turing machine Turing machine is a mathematical model of computer system which compute the mathematical function like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and it also act as a the language acceptors. When you are giving the language to the machines, it will calculate the language of that machines. Okay, so the formal definition of the Turing machine, it is always represented as a 5-tuple notation, that is capital M is equal to 7-tuple notation, that is Q summation delta to Q0 blank and F. So the formal definition of Turing machine is, it is always represented as a 7-tuple notation, that is M is equal to Q summation delta to Q0 B and F, and each one having a different meaning. Okay, as we have seen in the last lecture, that is where Q is a finite set of state, summation is the input symbol, delta is the transition function, to is the allowable tape symbol, Q0 is the initial state, B is the, yes, what is B? B is the blank symbol, right, and F is the final state, finite set of final state. Okay, so this Turing machine compute the, as I told you that the Turing machine compute the mathematical operation like addition it perform, subtraction it perform, multiplication, division, and also act as a language acceptor. Okay, so there are different kind of the Turing machines model is there, different model. So M plus N is a one model, M minus N is a second model, M star N is a third model, and M by N. Okay, so there are four model in the Turing machine. We will compute the one by one. So first of all, we will see the addition model. See, this Turing machine is a, that the meaning suggests that it is not stationary. Okay, it is not fixed, it moving from one place to the another place. Okay, like if you listen, you recall the name, like Turing talkies are the concept where it is not unstable, so it move from one place to the another place. Okay, so with this topic you will be able to understand the design part of the Turing machine, then you will be able to design the model of the Turing machine, and you will be able to design the transition diagram, you will be able to design the formal definition of the Turing machine. Okay, let's see the first the model of the Turing machine, that is M plus N. Okay, in the earlier cases that you know that this addition of the two numbers, okay, addition of the two number means earlier life, there are the addition is performed on the basis of magnetic tape head, that addition is performed on the magnetic tape head, and magnetic tape head it consists of the input tapes, then finite control, and this finite control the whole input symbol. Okay, so in this case the same logic we will apply here, that to perform the addition. Okay, so first of all, while designing the addition model of the Turing machines, there are the four steps. Okay, how much steps? There are four steps. The first step is the logic. If you know the logic that how to perform the, how to compute the addition, it perform it has some own logic. On the basis of the logic, we will compute the additions. Okay, so first of all, we will see the addition model, that what is the logic of the addition, how we get the result M plus N is equal to whatever the result. Okay, so M is any numbers and N is the any numbers. Here we will see the first logic. M and N are the any numbers, okay, there is no any restriction, but for the understanding we will take the numbers that 2 plus 3. As we know that the computer understand only the 0 and 1 language, machine level language. So let's take an input like 2 0 and 1 separator and 3 input. This is 2, 1 separator and 3. Here is no symbol, means number of blank is present there on right hand side, and left hand side number of blank. Okay. So first upon, what is the logic that how to perform the, how to compute the addition? Like 2 plus 3, how we got the result 2 plus 3 is equal to 6. But remember that we are designing the addition model in generalize. M may be any numbers and N may be any numbers. So this is the input. Okay. So the logic is very simple, that 2 plus 0. So what is the logic that we will collect the, you know, the all the 0, means 2 plus 3 0, and we will get the 5 0. But how to understand that here this is the input? How to understand which is the input and which is the output? I mean, before that we have to create a one separator to differentiate that which is the input and which is the output. As this is the input, this is 3 plus 2 is the input, and in the output section we will get the 5 0. Okay, and that 5 0 will be placed in, you know, the right hand side. Okay. So there must be a one separator that who will differentiate which is the input and which is the output. Understood? So first upon we will take the input. So input 2 0 3 0, then we have to apply the logic. Look at this. So step first is how to create a separator. Initially the pointers are here. Look at this, the pointer is here. Then we will perform the operation blank to blank. Look at this. This is very important, that how we perform the operation blank to blank. Okay. So initially we are skipping all the 0 as it is, 1 as it is, 0 as it is, 0 as it is, 0 as it is. Then we will replace that blank with 2. When we replace that blank with 2 and turn the direction to left. Okay. Means blank with 2 and turn the direction to left. So left hand side we will search the blank. So left hand side we will search the blank. When we got the first blank in the left hand side, then we will replace the blank with blank and moving towards right. Look at this, we are creating the separators, then we are skipping as it is and we are searching the blank. We got the blank, then blank with blank and turn the direction to right. Okay, what we have done? The first step we are skipping all the 0. Initially we are on left hand side, correct? Then left hand side we will perform the operation like blank to blank. Okay, then we are on left hand side. First we will search the blank to the right hand side. When we got the blank, we will create a separator by replacing blank with 2, correct? Then blank with 2 and moving towards left. Then same process, we will search the blank to the left hand side. When we get the blank left hand side, we will replace that blank with blank and turn the direction to right. Then now it is important that we have to collect, we have to copy this first 0 with blank. We have to copy the first 0 with blank, and rest of the 0 will skip as it is, 1 as it is, 0 as it is, 0 as it is, 0 as it is, 2 as it is. We had copied the first 0. And we have to paste to the right hand side by replacing blank with 0 and turn the direction to left. Okay, what is the logic? We have to copy the first 0 and we have to paste to the right hand side of the, you know, the input symbol. Okay, so we have copied this 0 with blank and we have pasted to the right hand side, correct? Then same process we have to do this same process, that again we have to search the blank to the left hand side. When we get the blank, look at this, we are searching the blank, replacing, skipping as it is. So blank with blank and turn the direction to right. Okay, then next, copy the next 0, repeat the process, that second 0, 0 with blank. Okay, this one is a separator, make it blank, 0, 0, 0, 2, 0, and paste it by replacing blank with 0. Okay, again repeat the process. Search the blank to the left hand side. When we get a blank, replace that blank with blank and turn the direction to right. Okay, then copy the next zero with blank, then 0 0 2 0 0, replacing blank with 0 and turn the direction to right. Okay, again repeat the process, search the blank to the left hand side, we got a blank. So blank with blank, turn the direction. So 0 with blank, 0 2 0 0 0, and replacing blank with 0 and turn the direction to left. Again repeat the process, blank with blank, turn the directions, 0 with blank, 2 0 0 0 0, and replacing blank with 0 and turn the directions. Okay, so look at this. We are searching the blank to the left hand side. While searching the blank to the left hand side, we are getting the symbol 0 with 0, skipping as it is, skipping as it is, skipping as it is, we got a blank, blank with blank and turn the direction to right. Look at this, there is no any 0 present. Okay, no 0, it means that all the inputs are over. We, instead of 0, we are receiving the 2. What we are receiving? 2 means all the zeros are over, and this 2 is nothing but the separator between input and output. It means that we got the result. So at the last, replace this 2 with blank and turn the direction to left, and this is our output, that is 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. Okay, so let's recap here. See the logic, what we have done in the first steps. First step, we have created the, yes, what we have done in the first step, we have created the one separator. How we create a separator? By replacing blank with 2. Okay, blank with 2 and turn the direction to left. So left hand side, we are searching the blank. When we get the first blank to the left hand side, we will replace that blank with blank, and we have to change the directions. Okay, then copy the one first zero and paste it to the right hand side and repeat the process. Up to when you have to repeat this process? You have to repeat this process unless and until all the zeros are over. When all the zeros are over, it means that we got the result, that 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. Okay, but this is only for the, you know, this is 2 plus 3, but while designing the transition diagram, we will think about the, you know, generalized way how to calculate the additions. Okay, so everybody understood this logic, that how to calculate the addition, 2 plus 3 equal to 6. Okay, understood? Okay, so from this logic, I told you that designing the addition model, design the Turing machine for m plus n. So we have to design the Turing machine for addition. Okay, so addition, very important part is logic, that on which basis we will get the result that m plus n equal to is equal to the additions. Okay, so the logic is simple. We will collect the input one by one and we will paste to the right hand side. Okay, so this is the logic. Then second, this logic is important to design the, you know, the transition diagram. If you don't have the logic about how to compute that 2 plus 3 is equal to 6, then you cannot design the transition diagram. So first we have to design the transition diagram. Second step, every step is dependent to each other. I mean, first is logic. From the logic, you can easily design the transition diagram. From the transition diagram, you can easily draw the transition table, and at the last, the formal definition of the Turing machine. So this is what the complete, the, you know, the model of the Turing machine. Okay, so from the logic, how we calculate the transition diagram. Okay, so we will draw the transition diagram. Transition diagram. So this is what the steps 1. Look at this, in the logic what we have done. So Q0, what this indicate? Q0 is a initial state. What we have done initially on Q0 state, on Q0 state, we are skipping all the 0 with 0 move towards right, 1 with 1 move towards right. Look at this. We are skipping all the 0 with 0, number of 0 with 0 moving towards right, 1 with 1 moving towards right, 0 with 0 moving to right, then again 0 with 0 moving towards right. Then next we have to create the what? We reach to the second state, that is Q2. Okay, so we reach to the what? 2, 2 with blank and move towards left. Okay, look at this. Initially, we are skipping all the 0 with 0 moving towards right, 0 with 0 moving towards right, 1 with 1 moving towards right, then we reach to the blank. So, we have to create a one separator, that replacing that blank with 2, replacing that blank with 2, here, blank with 2 and move towards left. Okay, so blank with 2 and move towards left. Then next is blank with 2 and move towards left. Left we are searching the blank, left we are searching the blank. While searching the blank to the left hand side, we are skipping all the 0 with 0 move towards right, 1 with 1 move towards right. Okay, then we reach to the where we are reaching, blank with blank and move towards right. Look at this, we reach to the Q3 state. We reach to here, that replacing that blank with 2 and move towards left, blank with 2 and move towards left, then 0 with 0 move towards left, 0 with 0 move towards left. This loop indicate that number of zeros are moving towards the left hand side directions. Okay, number of 0, then 1 with 1 move towards left, then we reach to the blank. So blank with blank and move towards right. Here we have to copy the, we have to copy the 0 with blank and move towards right. Here we are copying. Here we are copying 0 with blank and moving towards right. We have copied this 0 with blank and moving towards right. Okay, then for rest of the 0 we will skip as it is. 0 with 0 move towards right, then 1 with 1 move towards right, and 2 with 2 move towards right. Look at this, we had copied the 0 with blank and move towards right, 1 with 1 move towards right, again 0 comes move towards right, 2 with 2 move towards right. So here we had copied this 0 with blank and moving towards right. So we had copied, then we have to paste to the right hand side. So we will paste it. How we paste this? Yes. How we paste this? We will paste this by replacing blank with 0 and turn the direction to left. Then we reach to the Q5 state. Isn't it? Initially we are skipping, we are on, you know, the right hand side. So we are skipping all the 0 as it is moving towards right. So we have copied this 0 with blank move towards right, then all the 0 we are skipping as it is, 0 as it is, 2 as it is, then we reach to the blank. Look at this, blank with 0 and moving towards left, blank with 0 and moving towards left. So left hand side we will search the, what we will search? We will search the blank, correct. Then so we will search the blank. While searching the blank to the left hand side, we are skipping 0 with 0 and move towards left. Very good. Then 1 with 1 move towards left, 2 with 2 move towards left. Look at this, blank with 0 moving towards left, 2 with 2 moving towards left, 0 with 0 moving towards left. Okay, then we reach to the, where we are reaching? We are reaching to the blank, you know, blank with blank and move towards right. Where we are reaching? Blank with 0 move towards right, then look at this, 2 with 2 move towards left, 0 with 0 move towards left, then we will search the blank. Okay, so blank with blank and move towards what? Blank with blank and move towards, so we will connect this, blank with blank here. Look at this, what we have done? We have done blank with blank, here we are reached to the blank with blank and moving towards right, correct. Then second 0, copy the second 0 with blank and paste to the left hand side. Okay, again go back to the, you know, where we have to go, this here blank with blank and move towards right, is it? Okay, again I will revise here. Look at this, what we had done in here. Q0, we are skipping all the 0 with 0, move towards right, then 1 with 1, move towards right. The next is we had copied the, you know, the we have created one separator. Step 1 is blank with 2. So blank with 2 and move towards left. So left hand side we have to search the blank. While searching the blank to the left hand side, we are getting the symbol 0 with 0, move towards left. 1 with 1, move towards left. Then we reach to the, where we are reaching? We are reaching to the blank. Okay, where we are reaching? Blank with blank and move towards right. Then next, copy the 0 with blank, move towards right. Then next, all the 0 we are keeping as it is, 1 as it is, 2 as it is, and moving towards right. We had copied this, then we have to paste that blank with 0 and move towards left. Okay, blank with 0 and move towards left. So we reach to the, where we are reaching? Q5. So Q5 again we have to search, what we have to search? Blank. Okay, that blank with blank and move towards right. Okay, so here we will write that blank with blank and move towards right. Okay, then again this process will be continue. Up to when this process will be continue? Means all the zeros are not over. Where the zero will be over? Tell me please. Here blank with blank, move towards right. Then all the, I told you that when all the zeros are over, it means that there is no zero for copy. There is no zero for copy. Okay, so no zero means instead of zero, we will get the what? We will get the 2. Okay, means that this loop will not be continue. Okay, here this loop will be break. Okay, that 2 with blank and move towards left, that machine will be halt here, that is Q6. What this double circle indicate? Yes, what this double circle indicate? This indicate the final state. Okay, Q6 is what? The final state, Q5, and at last is Q6. Again, look at this diagram. This is what the complete transition diagram. Okay, this is what the transition diagram. Again, here I told you that blank with blank and move towards right. Then 0, we are getting the 0. Okay, 0 with blank and move towards right. Okay, then we are getting the 1 with 1, move towards right. 0 with 0, move towards right. Then we reach to the, where we are reaching? We are reaching the Q5 state, that we are copying the 0 and we are paste to this side. Again, we are searching the blank, we are copy the second 0 and we are pasting. Again, we are searching the blank, then third 0 we are copying and pasting. Likewise, this loop will be continue. Up to when this loop will be continue? This loop will be continue up to when this loop will be continue, all the zeros are not over. Means all the zeros are not present. Look at this, that all the zeros are pasted on the right hand side. Instead of 0, we got the 2. So 2 with blank and move towards left. Then the machine will be halt here. In this way we will get the 2 + 3 = is not 2 + 3 = 6. This is what the generalized transition diagram of m + n. Okay, generalize means m may be any numbers and n may be any numbers. Here if you see that we have applied the loop, it's indicate, it is not this loop indicate not the particular numbers. Okay, that loop indicate the infinite times that loop is limited. Suppose for example 1 lakh + 1 lakh. So the logic is that this loop will be repeated up to when? 1 lakh times. Clear? This loop will be repeated up to when? 1 lakh times. So this is what this is the complete generalized transition diagram of m + n, that is m may be any numbers and n may be any number. For sake of understanding we took the example that 2 + 3. Okay, that how we get 2 + 3 = 6. Okay, but while designing the transition diagram we will think on generalized way. Okay, so this is what the transition diagram. Then step 2 is what? This is step 1 and this is step 2. Step 2 is transition table. So this transition table we can draw from the transition diagram. Okay, the first is what? The logic, that how to compute the addition. This is the logic. This is not counted in the steps. So step started from this, that transition diagram, then transition table, and the third step is a formal definition. Okay, so from the transition diagram you can easily draw the transition tables. Okay, so this transition table which we can draw from summation
versus Q. Summation versus Q. So this is input, summation means input symbol. So you have to write the input symbol 0, 1, blank and 2.
And here you have to write the all the, you know, the all the state. You have to write all the complete state that which you have used in the transition diagram. Okay. So next part we will see in the next session. Let us see the steps 2. Steps 2 is transition table. We call as delta. So how we draw the transition table? Transition tables, in the steps 2 transition table we can draw from that step 1, that is transition diagram. Okay. So transition tables which we will draw, summation versus Q. We will draw summation versus Q. So what is summation? Summation is the input symbol. Okay. So which are the input symbol which we have used in the transition diagram? Yes. Which symbol we have used in the transition diagram? 0, very good. 1, very nice. Blank and 2. So these are the input symbol which we have used in the transition diagram. And Q is what? The finite set of state. So finite state of, how many state we have used in the transition diagram, that we have to write in the Q version. So Q0, here this arrow indicate the start state. Q0, Q1, then Q2, then Q3, then Q4, Q5 and Q6. Okay. Here in this Q means how many state, Q is a finite set of state, that how many state we have used in the transition diagram. So look at this, that how to draw the transition table. On Q0 state giving input 0, on Q0 state giving input 0, where we are reaching actually? On Q0 state giving input 0, where we are reaching? We are reaching itself Q0. So here you have to write that Q0 0R. Okay. So on Q0 state, giving input 0, where we are reaching? We are reaching Q0 0R. Similarly, on Q0 state giving input 1, where we are reaching? Again we are reaching to the, where we are reaching? Q0 1R. Then on Q0 state giving input B, is there any input B from Q0? No. So write the dash. On Q0 state giving, input blank, is there any blank input? Look at this, Q0 state giving input, blank, where we are reaching? Look at this, Q0 state giving input B, where we are reaching? We are reaching to the Q2. So here we are reaching to Q2 blank L. Okay. Then next is Q0. On Q0 state giving input 2, is there any 2 input from Q0? No. So just write the dash. There is no input, from Q0, from Q0 state by giving the input 2. Okay. There is no any 2 input from Q0. Then next, similarly on Q1 state, so likewise on Q1 state giving input 0, where we are reaching? Then Q1 state giving input 1, where we are reaching? Q1 state giving input B, where we are reaching? Okay. So Q1 state, so here Q0 and Q2, so here instead of Q2, we are giving input to 0, we are reaching to, where we are reaching? We are reaching to the Q2 0 L. Clear? On Q2 state giving input 0, we reach to the Q2 0 L. Okay. Then on Q2 state giving input 1, where we are reaching? We are reaching to the Q2 1 L. On Q2 state giving input B, where we are reaching? Q3 B R. On Q3 state giving input 2, so no input, so write the dash. Then next is Q3. On Q3 state giving input 0, we reach to the Q4,
on Q3 state giving input 0, Q3 state giving input 0, we reach to the Q4 BR. On Q3 state giving input 1, is there any input B? No, dash. Q3 state giving input B, is there any B? Dash. Q3 state giving input 2, where we are reaching? Q6 BL, isn't it? Then similar for the Q4. Q4 giving input 1, we are reaching to the, where we are reaching itself, Q4 1R. On Q4 state giving input 1, here not the 1, 0. Here Q4 1R. Then Q4 2R. Q4 2R. Is there any blank input? Yes. Q5 0L. Q5 0L. Then next Q5 state. On Q5 state giving input 0, on Q5 state giving input 0, where we are reaching? We are reaching itself Q5 0L. On Q5 state giving input 1, where we are reaching? Q5 1L. On Q5 state giving input blank, is there any blank input? Yes, it reached to the Q2 BR. And 2, is there any 2 input from Q0, Q5? No. So we write the dash. At last Q6. So Q6, is there any 0 and 1 input? No. So write the dash, dash, dash and dash. So this is what the transition table which we have drawn from the transition diagram. So in the transition table, we have to draw the summation versus Q. In the summation section, we have to write all the input symbol, and Q, we have to write all the finite set of state. And this Q6 is nothing but the what? The final state. This final state indicated as a double circle. Okay, so this is what the steps to transition diagram which we have drawn from the logic, steps to which we have drawn from transition table which we have drawn from the transition diagram. If you understood the logic, you can easily draw the transition diagram. Once you understood the transition diagram, you can easily draw the transition table. And at the last, the steps 3 is nothing but the final formal definition.
What is the formal definition of Turing machine? M is equal to Q summation delta to Q0 blank and F. So you have to write the formal definition of the Turing machine, that is 7 tuple notation, and each one having a different meaning. Q is what? The finite set of state, means you have to write all the state. Summation is the input symbol, delta is the transition function, tau is the allowable tape symbol. What is tau here? Allowable tape symbol. So allowable tape symbol is separator 1 and B and 2. So this is what the allowable tape symbol. Summation is what? The input symbol, that is 0 and 1. Q0 is what? The initial state. Q0 is what? Initial state. And F is what? F is, which is the final state in the transition diagram? Q6. Okay. So this is what the third step, that is formal definition of the Turing machine. Okay. So what we have done in the designing of the Turing machine? As I told you that once you understood the designing part of the Turing machine, that you will be able to design the transition diagram, you will be able to design the transition table and the formal definition. Okay, so what we have done in the first, we have done the logic. Okay, that how to compute the addition, that is m plus n. Okay, and this is generalized. M may be any numbers and n may be any numbers. Okay, first of all we will see the logic. Then from the logic we have designed the transition diagram. Okay, once you understood the transition diagram, logic, you can easily draw the transition diagram. Then step 1, this is step 1. Then steps 2, we have drawn the transition table, and this transition table is nothing but the delta which we have drawn from the transition diagram, and this transition diagram is summation versus Q. And the last third step is a formal definition. At the last you have to write the formal definition of the Turing machine, that is capital M is equal to this 7 tuple notation. Okay, that each one having a, here you have to write the Q is what? The finite set of state. Summation is the input symbol, delta is the transition function, tau is the allowable tape symbol, Q0 is the blank, Q0 is the initial state, B is the blank symbol, and F is the F is what? What is F? F is a finite set of final state. Clear? So yes, what we have seen, how to design the Turing machine? Yes, first is what? The logic, good. Second, transition diagram. Third, transition table. And fourth one, formal definition. Okay, so this is all about the computational model of the Turing machine. Okay, so next lecture we will see the how to design the Turing machine for the multiplication. Okay, what is the logic that how to compute the multiplication, that is m into n. Okay, next lecture we will see how to design the m into n, I mean the design the Turing machine for multiplication. Okay, I hope you understood. You will be able to design the logic, you will be able to design the transition diagram, transition table and the formal definition. Thank you.